So, like, since we want to go for Erwin, which is a data modeling tool. So, when we are talking about this Erwin tool, as we know that it can be used for ER data modeling. Basically, it is for ER data modeling. But the Erwin tool can also be used for dimensional modeling. So, when we are talking about data modeling, so the very first thing is like, what is the data modeling? Because once we understand the basic concepts of data modeling, like what is the entity, how they are related. So using this tool means what are the advantages we get, what are the benefits we get. That is the only, means it is like if we are not using a tool, still we can do the data modeling. Like before this tool, we used to design the database. And it was like we used to have a Microsoft products like PPT or other. So it was like we used to draw the diagrams. Then means it is like draw one box within that, write the name of that entity, then draw another box, write the name of the entity. When it comes to relation, you use the arrows or lines and to get them. So it looks good, means okay, we are able to draw the diagram. But the problem was there, once the diagram is drawn and we want to translate them into database script, means using those diagram, we want to generate the database. How we do that? So that was the challenge, because these are simple pictorial diagrams and they cannot be converted into database directly. So it was like, again, we go back to our database level, like SQL plus or whatever tool is there, and we write those commands one by one again. So we type. So it is like you want to draw the diagram, you take one tool, you want to write them in the script, means generate the SQL commands or whatever. Then you go to other tool and you type the things there. Then there was another problem. Suppose if we are going to restructure the existing database, it means like database is already there and we are required to make some changes. So since business has got maybe a new business process or they have changed their existing business process, so we have to restructure our database. Now the problem is for restructuring is if we are going as a data modeler, the first thing we need to understand the existing database, what tables are there, how they are related. So we have to get existing database diagram, which we refer as a ER diagram. If it is a entity relation or if it is a dimensional modeling, then we have to get the dimensional diagram. Now question is how to get. So before this tool, it was like we have to again open our database, go to the database tool, see the list of the tables, then take the printout of the table structure, check the relation, and then come back to your designing tool. Again, you draw those boxes, draw the lines and relate. So it used to take like days or weeks to draw the reverse ER diagram. So this kind of problem we faced without using this modeling tool. So when the modeling tool came, the three basic advantages which we got from the modeling tool was, the first one was referred as reverse engineering. Reverse engineering is a process where your tool, means any modeling tool, connects to the database. Whatever tables are there, whatever relations are there, these tools themselves will connect to the database. Once you give the connection string or connect string, they will extract the complete table structure, they will extract the complete relation, and based on those table structure and relation, they will draw a diagram, means pictorial diagram, which is like, means within the seconds or within minutes, depending upon the number of tables, you will be able to get the complete ER diagram or dimensional diagram. So you are not going to waste weeks or days to draw those existing database tables diagram. So that we refer as a reverse engineering. So reverse engineering in a very simple way is preparing a data diagram using the database. So in database, your tables or data structures are there. Using that, you prepare a diagram. So it is referred as the reverse engineering. And once you get the diagram, means you will be able to see how many tables are there, how these tables are related. So visibility is very proper. Means within a string, you are able to see your 30, 40, 50 tables. Or if suppose number of tables are 100, 200, 500, or 1000, like in case of ERP. For that, we cannot see in one single. So what we do is we break them into different subject area. So it is like suppose if we have a company database which has a 200-300 tables. So instead of viewing the entire data structure or diagram at once, what we do is we break it. Like HR data model means whatever tables are related to HR module, we define them separate. Whatever are related to sales or inventory, maybe like finance, accounts and finance. So we try to break the whole big data model into smaller pieces. which we refer as a module. Sometimes we refer them as a module, sometimes we refer them as a process wise or department wise. So there may be different criteria how we distribute these objects. So that is a very means a big advantage of using the modeling tool is reverse engineering. Second is once your data model are ready, means your pictorial diagram is ready, like these are the maybe 30 entities, they have a relation. Now I need to transform these entities or diagram into database. So in your modeling tool, you will get one option which we refer as a forward engineering. Forward engineering means using your model, means your diagram, you create the database. So the tool itself is going to take care of that part, means how to generate the SQL commands, how to execute those SQL commands at the database level if the connectivity is provided. So that also they will take care. So again, it is like within the seconds or minutes, your entire model will be converted into a database script, and then it goes and create the database object. So that is a forward engineering. So these two, which used to take earlier weeks time, now they are done within minutes or maybe sometimes maybe some hours, but not more than that. And the third is like, suppose if our database design is done, it is implemented, entire project is running. Now after 6 months, some changes are required by the client. So here it is like we have a model which is available in the tool, means file, and we can open with the tool. And then something is at the database level. Now problem is when practically things are implemented, sometimes what happens, developers are different, the database users, they keep on adding the objects at the database level, but they forget or they don't care to update the data model. So it is like after 6 months, some more tables are added in the database, or columns are added, or relations of the tables are changed. Now whatever model we have, it becomes like old version model, because so many things are added in the database. So if I want to update my model with the existing new data structure, whatever relations are changed or structures are changed. So there is a third option with these modeling tools, which we refer as a complete compare or model compare. So what these tool will do is they will take your data model file and they will take your connection to the database. So from database, they generate latest data model and then they compare both the data model. So your old data model and the latest one. And whatever changes are there, those changes they will reflect. And these changes reflection is both the side. It can be like from database, you can reflect the changes to data model, or from data model you can reflect changes to database, or if suppose both sides there are some changes, you can update both. So this is another great advantage of using the modeling tool. So these three are the very basic requirement for database designing or data modeling. So forward engineering, reverse engineering, and complete compare. Apart from that, designing the things in the modeling tool. Let me start this Erwin tool. So I will give you the idea like how this Erwin tool, and when I'm talking about this forward and reverse engineering, how it works. If you have any question, you can ask, you can interrupt me in between any time and you can ask questions. Don't wait for completion of the topic or demo session. So this is the Erwin tool. So this is the plan. It's the very first time it will look like this. So once we create one Erwin project, so at this time it is talking about like which model you want to create. Do you want to go for logical model or physical model or logical come physical model? So when we go for modeling, so in the data modeling, it is like we generally prepare three different type of model. One is a conceptual model, second is a logical model, and the third is a physical model. So when we are working with the Erwin tool, there is no conceptual model, because within the logical model itself, we prepare the conceptual model. So the difference between conceptual model and logical model is, in case of conceptual model, we just define the entities and the relations. But in case of logical model, apart from this, we add the attribute and the business rule. So that is the only difference. So in the logical model itself, we take care of these two parts. So when we want to show only the entities and relations, we change the display label. And we want to show the attributes and business rule, then we have another display label. So we create two display labels. One to show only entities and relations, which is conceptual, and the second one is to show including the attributes and the business rule, that becomes logical. And physical model is which is directly related to your database. And there will be a wide gap between the conceptual logical and the physical model. So when we design the conceptual model and logical model, we don't discuss or we don't include anything related to the technical side, means nothing from database side or computer or network. Whatever language we use in the conceptual and logical model is a pure business language, which user will be able to understand, because purpose of conceptual and logical model is to interact with the user, whatever requirement has been collected from them. Based on that, we design the conceptual logical model. Then we go back to the users just to cross-check whether whatever is the understanding as a data modeler about the user's requirement, whether those understandings are proper, means properly understood or not. And if there is any gap, then user will tell you that, okay, no, this relation between two tables you have defined is not correct. It should have been from the third table. So all those differences, all those misunderstanding between the modeler and the user has to be removed, and both the people should be at the same page. So that is taken care by the conceptual and logical model. So the primary purpose of conceptual and logical model is make sure that whatever is the user's requirement is understood by the data modeler in a proper way or in a complete way. And once that is done, then the next step comes how to transform this conceptual logical model into physical model. So what happens when we discuss about the conceptual model? So we discuss about the customer. So whatever attributes are there for customer, suppose 30, 40, 50 or 100 attributes, all we show in the customer. But when we transform this customer entity into a table, database table, which is physical model, it might be possible we may require 4, 5, 6 or more tables just for customer data. So it is like one conceptual model entity might translate into multiple tables at the physical level. So that is the difference between a logical and conceptual model. And we should never try to make both the model very similar looking or very exactly same looking. If that is the case, it means either your logical model is not correct or your physical model is not correct. So when we are going to create a model in this Erwin, so if suppose you are designing a conceptual or logical model, then you can take this option. If you are working at the physical, then you click on the physical, and the time you go for physical, it says select the database. And Erwin basically supports all these popular databases, whatever we are. So actually, when we design the physical model, we don't design the physical model for a specific database system. But here it asks, okay, if it is Oracle, they say we create the physical model as per the Oracle. But it is not a restriction. At any point of time, you can change your database from Oracle to SQL Server or DB2. So whatever changes are required, like suppose data type mismatch between Oracle and SQL Server, these tools automatically will take care of that. But sometimes it may be possible that some of the data types the tool does not understand with the current version. So it will list you all those things which are not understood by the tool in the terms of data type or size, so that you can go and change it manually, and then you can move from one database to another database. But the preferable is you go for logical and the physical. Suppose if you are designing a new database, so it is like you design the logical model, go with the user, discuss with them, make it proper understanding, and once it is done, then it is advantage is like moving from logical to physical will be just single click. So sometimes it is possible that whatever objects we have defined in the logical model, maybe 30-40% of the objects you can use in the physical model as it is. So advantage is going with this is just to take your logical model into physical, whatever changes you require you make it, so you can reuse 30-40% or maybe more. So you will save that much of time. So that is the advantage of using logical and physical both. And once you create this, means you go ahead with this creation of the model. So what Erwin does, it will create one file, and whatever work you do, it is going to save in the file. Now within this, there are so many windows will be there that we'll discuss in the regular section. Here just I will demonstrate. Like here, moving from logical to physical is the single click. So now if you see the left side, this is the Explorer window. Here the objects are whatever objects you can see, all these are database objects. But the time you go to the logical, you'll find that nothing related to database. All these are pure logical terms. Means whatever terms are required at the business level, only those terms are there. So this is like a very easy, means moving from logical to physical. Apart from that, we have options like under tools, reverse engineering, complete compare. So when we are at the logical level, there is no forward engineering, because logical model cannot be converted into database. But if you go to the physical, then you'll find there is a complete reverse and forward. All the three options are there. So when we are working with this modeling tool, suppose if you are going with existing database, then we can go for reverse engineering. Like I will just show you one example. So I'm going with this physical. Here I can do the reverse engineering using the database, or suppose if there is a script file, means SQL file, using that also we can do the reverse engineering. So I take this database, here bottom we can select whatever objects are required. So I will keep it all by default. Then it comes to tables or views from which user, so we'll go for current user. Rest of the things I'm skipping right now. Now here it says give the database username, so I can give like Scott user. And database connection. Once your connection is to, means connection information is given proper, then it will try to first evaluate what are the objects in your database schema. So tables, views, synonym, sequence, whatever database objects are there, it will first analyze all those objects and then get those details one by one and prepare a proper diagram. So some of the objects we know at database level which are visible, but there are so many other objects like table space, segments, rollback segment or other, which are pure internal objects, means backend objects. So they will be available in the model, but they will not appear in the page, means whatever pages are we are designing, which we refer as a display. So generally reverse engineering takes time because it has to analyze the entire database. And the second thing is I have selected all the objects, it means it is going to check each and every database object. And during this stage basically it checks through data dictionary. So every database has its own data dictionary, it is going to check from there, so which takes more time. See, this is the diagram. So you can see like in Scott schema, in my system, three tables are there. So we got all those three tables. There is no relation. There is no primary key defined for this. Like you see, the top portion basically is for primary key. So none of the table has a primary key and also there is no relation. So now we got this database, which is just three tables. Now what I want is I want to go for a proper primary key. I want to make the relation. So what we can do is like we open these entities. So if you see these modeling tools are basically GUI tool, like department number should be primary key. So here we click on the general tab, check it, it becomes primary key. As soon as you define primary key, it goes in the key section. The same for employee. So employee number should be primary key. Cell grade table, we have a grade as a primary key. Now to make the association, Erwin provides three type of relation. One is referred as an identifier, other is a view or materialized view relation, and second is non-identifier. So I want to relate department with employee. So it is like select any of the relation type that we'll discuss later. Click on the parent table, click on the child table. Now here it says that this primary key department number is already in the employee table. So it says do you want to replace with that, or you want to rename or create another. So we'll say the replace. So relation will be done. In the same way, like the cell grade and employee has a relation, so I can go for this cell grade to employee. Since grade is not there, so what it will do is it will create grade table directly. So in this employee table, there are two foreign keys. And here advantage is all these things graphical, like relation, you can manage, means you can define the way you want. So this I made changes at the database level. Now what I want is using this data model, update the data, means whatever database structure is there, I want to recreate. So I can go for tools, formal engineering, schema generation, and here again all these objects are there. Whichever object you want to reflect in database, you can select, check, uncheck the option, or if you can go for all. So here before you create the database, there is the option preview. So advantage with preview is it will give you a complete SQL. So you can see like create table, create unique index, alter table for primary key, imply, then there is a foreign key. So these are the complete script which is generated. You can run this script directly from here, or maybe you can save this script in a file, send it to the DBA of the database, and those DBA will take care of. They will run this file and generate the database. So here itself, if you see the generate option is there. Now it says that name is already used by existing. So since already table with the department name is there. So when it is trying to recreate the table, what happens, this table is already there, so it says name is already used. So one of the option is like at the table level, you can go and increase this up, means select the option, drop table. Now if you preview, you will find that before create, there is a drop option. So first it will drop all the tables and then create. So this time if you generate, we should not get the error. The three queries succeeded successfully. But the problem is if your table already have a data and then you say drop the table, so entire data will be lost. So in this case, what we generally do is take the backup, recreate the structure, and then load the data from those backup table to this one. So that is one way. Second way may be like don't go for forward engineering, instead go for compare. Means compare the model with the database, and whatever the changes are done, like primary keys added, so it will just add those things instead of dropping the table and recreating the table. So with this data modeling tool, this kind of advantage there means whatever job is going to take you for days or weeks, you can complete within minutes or hours. And that is the benefit of using the tool. But one thing should be very clear, data modeling process and data modeling tool, there is a wide gap. Means like some people, they get confused that if I am using a data modeling tool, then that tool is going to design the entire data model. That is not the case. Data modeling process means designing the data structure, defining the relations, all these are data modeling process which you have to learn. Means anybody wants to become a data modeler, first he has to learn the data modeling process. Means how I identify the entities, how I make the relation, what is the criteria to decide whether these attributes should go to this entity or that entity. And whether for one entity should I create one table or multiple tables. So these are based on some set of rules. And those rules are referred as ER data modeling or dimensional modeling. Or there is a third data modeling which has come very recently, about 2 years back. We refer as a data vault modeling. So these three different types of modelings are there. ER modeling we use for OLTP database design. Dimensional modeling we use for data warehouse design. And data vault modeling, again, we use for data warehouse design, which provides more flexibility and scalability. So don't think that using the data modeling tool, you will be able to create the data model or database. Designing the database structure is basically based on your domain knowledge and based on how strong you are in the modeling approach, means how better you understand the whatever rules are there for modeling. So if you are going for ER modeling, what is the meaning of entity, what is the meaning of attributes, what is the different type of relations which can be done among the entities, how we define the, decide the relation, one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-many. So when we are working with the RDBMS, it says that many-to-many relation cannot be done. So how we transform many-to-many relation into one-to-many and many-to-one with the help of third entity or third table. So those are the different set of rules which comes under data modeling. And tools are basically to help the data modeler to complete those data modeling job or task in a very short period of time. So when we are talking about this data modeling process, so since I'm not very sure whether you are for only Erwin tool or you are for data modeling plus Erwin tool. Generally, the people who come for data modeling training, they come for like data modeling training with the Erwin tool. And sometimes it is like people, they already know the data modeling tool. They just want to do the, so it means they know the data modeling process. Thus, they want to learn the tool so that they can use the tool for their data modeling process. So if suppose you are coming for the tool, so learning tool is one thing. Means it is like within the tool, how we create the entities, how we make the association, how we do this forward, reverse, or complete compare. So those are the some basic things, how we perform. That is the tool level. So that tool navigation, tool flow is one part. But if your thing is like, okay, I want to become a data modeler, I want to learn the data modeling process, how we identify entities, how we make the relation, what is the conceptual model, how we work on that, then that is a different part. So it is a part of your data modeling process. So is there like any query from your side, or is there anything you want to clarify? So like I was talking about this different type of ER model. So here we have ER data modeling, dimensional modeling, data vault modeling. And after that, it is like when you are working at the modeling level, what are the different models you need to create? So conceptual model, logical and physical model, which we have discussed earlier. Then it is like, what is the conceptual model? So basically, conceptual model is prepared by the business analyst or data modeler. Now, these two are two different persons. So when we are talking about data modeler, a data modeler is someone who knows the data modeling process. And if the data is provided, it means the information is provided, he will be able to translate those business data into a proper data structure. So that is the data modeler. But the thing is like, who is going to gather this information from the client? Means what client requires, what he already has, what entities or process he is dealing with. So those requirements we have to gather and prepare a document like a business requirement document or business requirement data. So who will gather that? So basically the person who is expert to that particular domain or who understand the process where users are working, so only those people can go and interact. So those people, we refer them as a business analyst. Means they understand the business and they are going to analyze the business requirement with the help of users who are involved in that process or in that domain. So sometimes what happens when you are working with the big corporates, like big development companies, Satyam is not there, it's like Infosys, TCS, or Tech Mahindra, Cognizant. So these companies are very clear, like for each task, they have a separate person. So for business requirement gathering, they will use a technical, means a functional guy who is expert in the domain. So he will go and collect the requirement, prepare a document, and pass it to data modeler. Now data modeler will study those documents. Based on that, they will design the data models. But when you are working with like a mid-sized development companies or solution provider or a small, then you will find that they will not have a separate resources for each and every role. So it is like multiple roles will be combined for one person. So it is like a data modeler himself has to go and study the requirements. So he will be like a business analyst from data modeler. So that kind of things will be combined. So when you are working or targeting as a data modeler, so sometimes it is possible that you have to go and gather the requirement, prepare the document and come back, do the modeling also. So whatever may be your role, so it may be possible you are a data modeler, but you are doing the job of business analyst. So at the conceptual data modeling level, basically it is the job of business analyst to get the requirement from user, based on that prepare a model, and then go back to the user and cross-check whether understanding is perfect or is there any change. And this conceptual model will deal only with the subjects, process and their relationship. So apart from this, nothing else should be there. Means we don't go at the attributes level or individual data level. Just we go for subjects and process. So we refer them as the entities. So we try to identify the entities, make the relation, and then discuss whether whatever entities I identified, they are correct. Whatever way I have related them, they are proper. Type of relation which is identified is correct. If the client says yes, so we take the sign off. Basically, sign off is a process which is an approval process, means approved by the user that your understanding is perfect. Once it is done, then we go to the next phase, which is a logical data model. Again, this logical data model is prepared by the business analyst or data modeler cum business analyst. Now, what he will do is he will extend these entities and add the attributes and whatever are the business rule, means which we refer as a constants, database constant. So he will add, and then again he will go back and see, okay, these entities are, these are data. So basically it is the cross checking whether whatever data is required by the client or users, whether all those data elements are captured, and whatever business rules are there, whether those are defined or not. So once that is approved by the client, means signed off, now you have a conceptual model which is converted into logical, and that approval is there. Now it means from user side all the input is over. Now as a data modeler you can come back, and then you prepare the physical model. So during the preparation of physical model, you don't require any input from the user because all those things are already completed at the conceptual and logical model level. So using this logical model, you are going to prepare your physical data model, which basically is defined in the terms of database. So physical data model is prepared by the data modeler. So your business analyst is not involved, or if you yourself are business analyst, that knowledge will not be used at this level. And since the physical data model is a very technical document, means it is a technical piece. So whatever physical model we prepare, we don't share with the end user or client, because those are functional guys. They will not understand your technical things. But nowadays what happens, there is a new trend with the clients. Most of the clients basically, they keep one or technical person or maybe a team of technical people, which we say IT department. So those technical people, they will demand that you share your physical model with us. We want to check whether have you designed this physical model in the best possible way. Means have you used the best practices to design? Because what happens in the past, many times, people who design the physical data model, they themselves are not very expert. So they design the data model which is faulty. So it gets implemented with some patch application development or patch programming. But in future, when the client goes for extension of the database because of new requirement, and when they recruit, hire a new consultant, that consultant says that this database design is very faulty, means lot of loopholes are there. And to implement your new business requirement, I have to restructure this again. So it is like client is facing, means again he has to put the budget and he has to spend a lot of time to restructure and then implement the new one. So since this has happened past many times, so now most of the clients, they say that I don't want to take a risk. So whatever is the physical model you are doing, you share with my technical person or team, let them verify, and if they find it is perfect, then only they approve, and then only development can start. So this is basically a very means common trend in the industry, because nowadays clients do not believe on the solution provider the way they have implemented in the past or the problem they have faced. So it is like this physical data model also you have to share with the client, their technical people, and once they approve, then only we can go for development. So when we are talking about this data modeling, so if it is a ER data modeling, the basic concept is involved with the entities and relationships. So what is the entity and what is the relationship? That is the primary thing. So entities basically is like when we go and discuss with the client about their requirement. So how we identify the entities? So there are means two different ways are used for identifying the entities. One is if suppose you have a domain knowledge, so with the domain knowledge you can go and identify what are the subjects and what are the process. So whatever things are related to the subjects, we take them as an entity. Whatever things are process based, they are also entity. So subject based entities we refer as a master entity, and the process based entity we refer as a transaction entity. So if you have a domain knowledge, then it is very easy to identify the subjects and process, means entities. But sometimes what happens, if suppose your domain, like as a data modeler, the next question comes from the most of the people is, if I'm working as a data modeler and every 6 months or 1 year, I'm getting a project which is based on new domain. So I cannot be exporting all the domain. So how I identify the entities? So there is another way of identifying the things. If your English grammar is there, means if you are good in English grammar, not expert, just basic things are very good, then based on all that also we are able to identify the different entities. Like there is a relation between this master entities and transaction. So in English grammar we have a concept like means whatever are the noun based words, these are referred as a master entity, and whatever are the verb based, they are referred as a transaction. So for example, like people say customer is a master, product is a master, location is a master, country, city, state. If you see, all these are noun. So whatever words are noun based or whatever things are noun based, they are master entity. And the process, like when we say verb, like sales, dispatch, payment, receipt, return, deposit, withdrawal, all these are verb. So whenever you find some words are or some entities are based on verb, it means these are transaction entities. So once we understand this English grammar, or we start applying using English grammar, means if you are good in English grammar, then without the domain knowledge also, you will be able to identify the master entities or transaction entities, and you can make a database design which will be like about 60 to 70% you can make correct. But another 30% or 20 to 30%, you will not be able to do because domain knowledge is required. So the question comes, how I upgrade my domain knowledge? So as a data modeler, we don't have to upgrade our domain knowledge for each and every domain. So basically what happens when we stuck up with the domain knowledge, then your business analyst comes or functional guy comes. So your company will associate one functional expert of the domain, and whatever doubts you have, you will clarify from that functional person, and then you complete your data model. So it is not needed that, okay, you should be expert in each and every domain. Practically, it is not possible. So nowadays, companies also, they go for this approach. Whenever they are going for any big project, so for that project, they will keep one functional expert in that particular domain, and that functional expert will be part of the entire project cycle. So analyst, data modeler, even the developer, testing team, they all are going to use that functional expert knowledge whenever they have any doubt about the subjects and process. So here, when we are talking about ER modeling, we have like based on the real life entities and how they are related. So the entire ER modeling is based on the entities and relations. So what is the entity? Like a simple definition of entity is anything in this world which can be distinguished from other things is an entity. So anything means, like we say we are using laptop. Laptop is an entity. Means it is a computer. So we say computer is an entity. Mouse is another entity. Keyboard is third entity. Room where we are sitting is an entity. Door is entity. Window is entity. So anything which you are able to distinguish. So when I say window and door, so it is like the time we said window and the time we said door, one image comes in our mind, a very hazy image. But with the image itself, we are able to differentiate, okay, these two are two different objects. But suppose if I say Mr. A and Mr. B, so I know that Mr. A is a person and Mr. B is a person, but here I cannot differentiate except the name. So if suppose someone says Mr. A has a two legs, two hands, two eyes, two ears, so Mr. B also is a person, he has the same thing. So it means Mr. A and Mr. B are not entity, but they are entity instance, because Mr. A is a person and Mr. B is a person. So person is entity, and this person entity has many instances of person. So each instance in the database system we refer as a record. So it is like entity is an object which translates into database as a table, and the entity instance basically is a record. It goes in the data, but in the terms of table, it becomes a record. So entities are transformed into table, and entity instance are transformed as a record. So this is the way, like once you are able to identify the entities, now the problem comes when we go to the business data or business domain, there are so many entities are there. Most of the entities are non-tangible. So it is like very few entities will be physical, and most of the entities will be virtual. So virtual we refer as a non-tangible or abstract. Whatever things we are able to see and we are able to touch, we refer them as a tangible. But there are so many things which are not visible. It is our imagination based object. Like for example, we say student. So most of the people say student is a physical, but actually student is a logical. Physical is a person. Now the thing is, this person who is a physical object, he is doing one set of activity, so we refer student. When he does the other set of activity, we say employee. When he does the third set of activity, we say manager. When he does another set of activity, we say player. So it is like same person is involved in so many different set of activities, and for each set of activity, we have given a logical name, and that we refer as an entity. So student is an entity, employee is an entity, player is an entity, manager is an entity, father is an entity. So all these are entity, but all these logical entities are based on one physical entity, person. So when we go for designing of database, so we have to consider this physical entity and logical entity. Is it like whatever logical entities are there, there must be some physical base entity. So how we design the table structure? Should we keep two separate tables? Whatever properties belong to the physical entity, keep in one table, and whatever properties belong to the logical entity, keep in another table, and then make the relation between these two as a parent child. So should we do this? Or some people, they say, no, let us keep a separate table for student with all the attributes, whether physical attributes or logical, then other table for player with all the attributes. So many attributes will be repeating. But if you distribute them, physical attributes and logical entity related attributes, then we can avoid the repetition of data. So it is like instead of duplicating data in multiple tables, we can make it a separate table and we can distribute those attributes. So this is the way how we identify the entity, how we categorize the entity as a tangible or non-tangible. And then we see what are the attributes, because an entity is defined by its own attributes. So at least one attribute should be there for every entity, but generally there will be multiple attributes. So these whatever attributes are defining the entity, or whatever you say characteristics are different, like some people they say properties. So these attributes or properties which are defining the entity, again they are categorized into three parts. So some of the attributes are to define the identification of entity, some of the attributes they define the behavior of the entity, and some of the attributes they will define the appearance of the entity. Like attributes like color, height, weight, all these are basically to define the appearance. And attributes like designation, role, category, all these are basically they decide what is the behavior of the entity. And attributes like ID, name, type, they define the identity. So when we are talking about tangible entity or non-tangible entity, so if this entity does not have any appearance related attributes, it means it is a non-tangible. And if the entity has appearance related attribute like color, if anything is visible, there must be color. So if the color attribute is there with the entity, it means it is tangible. And if it is not there, that entity is a non-tangible. So when we identify the set of attributes for an entity, we check what is the group of attributes, identification attributes, behavioral attributes, or appearance. So it is like you first identify the entity, then identify the relations, and then you go for attributes. So when it comes to these entities, we have different types of entity: master entity, transaction entity, and reference master. So as we have already discussed, like master entities are basically noun based, which we refer as a subject based, and transaction entities are verb based. So if you don't want to go in the in this means master and transaction based, then it is like means you don't want to go for grammar based, then you go for master entity and transaction entity. What is the master entity? Those entities which are responsible to initiate the process or transaction, we refer them as a master. So like we say customer is a master entity. Why? Because customer initiates the sales process, customer initiates the payment process, customer initiates the dispatch process. So any process will not initiate by its own. So some entity will be responsible to initiate those process. So whatever entities are responsible to initiate the transactions or process, we refer them as a master. And the entities which are based on the process, we refer them as a transaction entity. Then there is one third category, reference master. So reference master basically is sometimes an entity is referred by a master entity. It means one master entity is using the reference from another master entity. So those master entities which are referred by another master, we refer them as a reference master entity. That is one of the features. But there is like reference master entities, another feature is generally they are static in the nature. It means data in those reference master entity will be very limited. So it is like city. We know that cities are predefined and they don't change very frequently. Very limited list of cities will be there. So that kind of entities we refer as a reference master entities. And then we have a different type of relations like one to one, one to many, and many to many. So if two entities relation is based on one to one, then we have to take a call whether these two entities should be kept separate or should be combined together.
Hello.
And if the entities are based on one to many relation, then generally we keep these two entities as a two separate table in the database. The third relation is which is many to many, how we handle, because RDBMS does not support many to many relations. So in that case we have to use association entities, and it is like we create third table to define the relation which are based on many to many. So like you see the product and customer, one product can be purchased by many customers and one customer can purchase many products. So both the side there is a many. So it means a relation is many to many. So as soon as this many to many relation comes, very simple rule, introduce one more table, and whatever is the primary key of these two entities, they should go to this third entity. So then association is done. So it becomes like one to many, many to one. And it is not like only primary keys of the parent entity will be in this association entity. There may be some other attributes, like suppose if you talk about the rate. So it may be possible that the same product has been purchased by different customer with a different rate. So if that is the case, the rate depends on customer and product both. So that should come to this associate entity. So apart from this primary keys of both the parent, there may be some attributes which are dependent on both. So both the means, so those attributes should come to this associate entity. Okay, so means if there is there any query or any question is there till this point? No, no, this is, that is why I'm not sure whether this training will be for Edwin tool only, or it is for ear modeling, or it is for dimension modeling, because many things are there. Okay. So I have covered like both, means I was trying to give something from Edwin tool and something from ear modeling. So
Because the the thing is that I am mostly aware about the database related things, right?
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is that I am more interested to regarding like the practical way how to this ER modeling tool is using, right? Using this concept here.
No, so that is why I mean it is like you just want to learn the Erwin tool. You want to learn the ER modeling with Erwin tool. There are two things.
Okay.
It is like some people, they come and they know already ER modeling, but they don't know the tool. So they want to learn the tool. So simply they go for some session, 5-6 session, and complete the tool and go. But people mostly, what happens, they come and they want to learn Erwin modeling approach. Means how I identify the entities, how I identify the relations, what is the way to interact with the user, how we gather the information. So those things are there. So that comes under ER data modeling process. So that is a conceptual, and then tool is very simple. Learning tool is not a big deal, but the thing is, the tool is not going to design your database or data model. It has to be done by your own mind. So you need to know the rules of the data modeling, like ER modeling rules or dimensional modeling rules. So that is another aspect.
And my question is, like, this ER modeling tool is commercial tool or open source free, or what kind of?
No, it is a commercial. It is not open source. Open source is like, if you want to go far, you can use the Oracle Data Modeler, which is open, means free, you can use it. And there are so many means data modeling tools are there, which are open source. But why Erwin is popular? Because of the simplicity and because of the feature they provide in a very simple way. That is why it is more popular.
Hey, you can go ahead with the rest of the session.
So from my side, the session is over, because there are so many things are there. So this is a since demo session. So purpose is like basically the people want to know like what is the communication, what kind of explanation approach is there. So that is there. I think that should be means enough, means whatever I have taken 1 hour, that should be enough too. Yes, Pandana, is there anything else from my side you need?
No, thanks.
So they understand. But when I find that okay, people are basically, our participants are non-working, means they have not worked till now. So I try to take more example from the real life or personal life, so that they can understand. So thing is basically, whatever technical terms or whatever functional terms are there, we should be very clear about the concept. And the best way of understanding is, you pick up the example which is nearby you, means within your house, within family. From there you pick up the answer. So then your concept will be clear. And once your concept is clear, then when you go for implementation at the practical level or physical level, it will not be challenged. Most of the time problem comes only when our concept is not clear and we are trying to create the technical things or we are trying to implement. So until the concept is very clear, working is not possible. So my approach is, first make the concept clear using the example which participants understand. So if you are like, suppose some college students are there, so then I take the example from college, means school and college, like what is the relation between a teacher and a student? Is it one-to-one relation, or it is one-to-many relation, or many-to-many relation? So they understand very easily, because one teacher teaches many students, and one student, since he goes for many classes, so many teachers are there. So there is a many-to-many relation. So if I have to translate into database, it should be like one table for teacher, one table for student, and one table to associate both of them because there is a many relationship. Then, okay, let us extend this. So this is three table. Now I'm going for maybe subject. So what is the relation between subject, teacher and student? So everybody will say subject has a relation with teacher because teacher is teaching. Subject has a relation with student because students are learning. So is it like, should I rate subject with teacher as well as with student? If yes, then it becomes circular relation, means it is like a loop. So in RDBMS it says that no circular relation should be there. So we have to discuss, okay, subject has a direct relation with teacher or direct relation with student, or it is like it has direct relation with both of them. If it is both of them, then I should relate the subject with some entity where both of them are joined. So like we have an association entity between teacher and student. So my subject should be related there itself, not to the teacher directly or not to the student. So this is the way we have to change our example. We have to pick up the example from a specific domain. So sometimes if suppose I get one participant is from college and other is from company working. So that time generally what I do is when I take example from company, this fellow doesn't understand who is a college student. So I take two example, means I have to take two example, one for this guy and one for that guy. So that both understand. So this is the way, means until we know our participant, it is not possible to teach, because this is not like a seminar. Seminar is a different thing. Seminar means one way. Person comes and he starts telling about the things. So there is no participant from the people who are attending. But when we are coming to training, it is different. And training purpose is to make the people understand so that they can go and implement practically. So there it has to be more interactive. So participants should take more, like whenever they have a doubt, they do not understand, they need to ask. So that is from the participant point of view. And the teacher has to take care of that. First understand the participant's level of knowledge and accordingly make your examples or whatever definition has to be given. Okay, so we can conclude this demo session if nothing else is there.